mano.
United States and the state delegation is very active and are very actively engaged in our activities. Stability in the region. And a very important point when looking at Russian support for a separatist movement area, I think it's a very, very clear evidence, very vivid evidence of the seriousness of this and graveness of this behavior. From our point of
view, their best to limit our ability to respond on the air and the land.
Thank you very much, George. Now the floor is to the president of Montenegro government,
the developed part of Europe, where nationalism is rising, as also in many other regions, and with it a growing feeling of...
We didn't know that we'd be seeing each other, George, just in the...
And we probably don't do the best job in the world of expressing.
I think I've had a lot of major points achieved, and some of those were...
The current challenges of our region, and also of our alliance. Dear members of the U.S. Senate and Congress, dear representatives of the U.S. administration, distinguished guests, I am very pleased to be part of this notable audience. Southeast Europe has been going through an epic transformation, rebuilding its future from the ashes of the Cold War and bloody conflicts which left the entire region in turmoil for a long time. Indeed, such a scenario could have continued as we speak unless our region had embraced the best model of security architecture in the history of mankind, NATO and the European Union. The peace process and the security design were backed by the NATO roadmap to fully anchor this region to the common security agenda of the alliance. We rely on additional US efforts and attention to complete the unfinished business in the Western Balkans. I am proud as I stand before you today, knowing that Albania has been and continues to be a vital catalyst to having the NATO and EU border extended, as they remain the basis of stability and prosperity in the Western Balkans. The region is still in a crucial phase. The challenging membership of Montenegro into NATO proved the need for a fully integrated region in the alliance. Equally important is the membership of Northern Macedonia after this historic agreement reached with Greece, as well as other countries in the region. As we continue to consolidate our democracy, state of law, the fight against organized crime, and the foreign influence that want to control this region, this crucial process doesn't actually go unchallenged. We are convinced that the final agreement between Kosovo and Serbia will produce peace, stability, long-term security in the region, with the United States and EU as guarantors. The results of this final agreement would mean that Kosovo is recognized by Serbia as an independent state and also full United Nations member. The only border change for which we must work night and day in our region is the full extension of the European frontier in the Western Balkans. Why should the United States remain focused on the region? We are realistic that mounting challenges that the United States is facing in the global arena, but not only, the EU transitions as well as the internal structural challenges that the alliance is facing demands full attention. It is time to raise the flag of a potential risk of leaving a vacuum in the region, which may be filled by religion extremism helped with some foreign powers. Only a few weeks ago, Albania expelled the Iranian ambassador in Tirana, along with one of their diplomats, who were jeopardizing our national security. The decrease and lack of effective coordination of United States and EU involvement in the Balkans could create a vacuum that would increase the presence of Russia and third actors in the region. The success of a lasting peace in the region is the result of the strong transatlantic partnership, which remains vital today despite differences. The stabilization of the region is in the interest of Russia, while its destiny of the region is in the EU and the NATO. During his visit in Belgrade, President Putin accused the United States and the European Union trying to seriously destabilize the region. Indeed, we would like that Russia respects the Euro-Atlantic aspiration of the countries in the region. We are realistic in understanding that the rival powers and actors that challenge the Euro-Atlantic alliance are tough, but we need to be persistent as we cope with these threats through a collective strategic partnership in such manner that always protects our region and the alliance's interests. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Mr. President. I appreciate your comments, but just to let know a little bit more the senators and also now is about this expelling of the Iranian ambassador. Iranian gave shelter to 3,000.
So I hope I can get a bit talk in that picture. Thank you very much. Thank you all. So I'm Vladimir. Vlado, and I'll get to stay and wait for me, please.
Robert, you